I'm Judge Beth Wolf. For more than 15 years, I worked as a prosecutor, putting bad guys where they belong and protecting the rights of crime victims. For the last 15 years, I've served you as a judge, ensuring the Constitution and your rights were respected. Now, I'm ready to serve on the Court of Appeals.
Well, even during the pandemic, Judge Jeff Johnson has a measure of routine here in a courtroom in A-Meet. But in particular, you're still holding court, but today, a happy part of your job, you got to swear in the clerk of court, Gary Stanga.
Absolutely. You know, Gary and I have known each other from years, both from the Ponchatoula community, so he asked me a few weeks back to do it, and I was happy to do so. He's got a good office and a good group of people that work for him.
Is that just about the happiest thing you get to do as a judge? Of course, you can marry people, right?
You can. It is one of the happier things you do. Certainly one of the things where you see people's hard work pay off. On occasion, that'll happen, and you'll see a success story in a criminal case where somebody really turns their life around or a victim gets justice. So there's other opportunities, but certainly among the top of them.
Well, in the meantime, how is court going, and how is it different from the norm?
I think it's going well, given the circumstances. I would probably describe it, Ken, as tedious. It's a little more time-consuming in the sense that I spend a lot of time trying to educate the public as a group. And when you're only able to bring in a small portion of people at the time, some things that you tell them you have to repeat several times. And while Zoom is a great way to facilitate moving the case further along, there's something that's lost not having that interpersonal conduct. Sometimes people speak over each other, not out of a place of disrespect, but simply because you're not in the same room or in the same place. That possibility exists. And then evidence issues, it's hard to share evidence via video conference.
So look, I have to ask you this question. Any attorneys who appear in your court via Zoom from their homes who are maybe not in proper attire, it's hard to stay dressed up when you're in your bedroom, let's be honest.
It is, and I think the rules are probably a little more laxed. You know, for me, and I think everyone's different, but for me it's about how you speak in a courtroom, and it's the honor, it's what you give the court, not Jeff Johnson, but what you give the court. And as long as that's presented, I don't have a real problem with the way they appear, because truth be known, you're only seeing them from chest up anyway.
That's what Walter Cronkite used to always say. But in any event, what percentage of the work you're doing now is remotely accomplished, and what percentage is in person?
I haven't really thought of it in terms of percentage. I would say civil work, more than 50% of it's probably done remotely. That started to change as we've gotten into June, but you know, we've had an uptick in cases, so you've seen a reservation for some people, so there's Zoom is starting to pick up speed. Criminally, maybe 50-50. Largely our prison population is being handled via Zoom. You know, DOC had some serious restrictions for a period of time, and that's actually worked pretty well. I've been pleased with the way that's worked, but some things we got to get them here to be able to accomplish, and that's when I guess the hiccups begin.
So have you conducted a jury trial yet?
We have not. We were just discussing that a moment ago before I came on camera. July 6th will be the first attempt here in Tangipahoa Parish to do a jury trial. The Supreme Court had a ban on juries through the end of June, so really this coming Monday is the first chance that we'll have to do that. And that'll again be a logistic issue. How do you get all these jurors in this place, keep less than 25%, keep them 6 feet apart? So it'll be a learning curve. This is one of those things that you can't go borrow from somewhere else. It's a case of first impression for everyone.
What else do you want to share with us?
Not a lot. I mean, I think that, I'm proud of the people of this parish, certainly the leaders in this community. You know, we've held conference calls on a regular basis. There's been a lot of cooperation amongst the sheriff, the clerk, the judges, the parish president. I really think that that egos and agendas have been put aside to try to accomplish what's necessary for the people of this parish, and I've been pleased and proud to be a part of that.
You know, the election dates have changed a bit this year with the pandemic, and it occurs to me that you're one of the judges who would be on the ballot this fall. That is, if you're running for re-election, so you can tell us now, I guess.
Oh, absolutely. I'm running for re-election. I've been blessed to be given this opportunity. I've tried to work hard and represent the people of this district, and, you know, I'd be pleased and honored to be able to do it another 6 years. And qualifying's a couple of weeks out, and that first day I'll be here qualifying and making every effort possible. And hopefully with the support of the people, we'll be able to do it for another 6 years.
Well, that's interesting. In just a couple of weeks, qualifying.
Yeah. it moves fast. You know, it just seems like yesterday you and I were talking on the campaign trail, and that's 6 years ago. You know, 6 years ago that I was campaigning. It was about this, it was June of 2014 that I'd announced that I was running for judge, and it's been a nice transition for us, and I've been honored to be able to represent the people of this district.
Judge Rick Swartz has served our community as an assistant district attorney, appointed judge pro tem by the Louisiana Supreme Court, and chief judge of the 22nd Judicial District. Promote Rick Swartz, a true conservative.